So I'm back with a new video, man. On it be to get 20, yo. It be to get 20, my career episode 28. Let's go right to it, yo. So, my boy, so going against the Chicago Bulls, yo. On Zach LaVine is injured, he will not be playing, bro. 6 to 8 weeks. Oh my god, bro. I wanna, man, it's all good, though. Going against Otto Porter, Young, Wendell Carter, Kobe White, Chris Dunn, Valentine. Going against those players, and Zach LaVine is not playing, so a pulled right calf muscle, 6 to 8 weeks. Man, that's bad, man. All right, let's get right into it. This is NBA 20, my career episode 28. You know what I'm saying, bro? Hey, y'all, bro, I'm going for 21. Triple W, so yeah. Hey, yo, this is Molly McCree, yo. We're playing against the Bulls on their home court, yo. It's a little boy. It's a little boy. It's a little, y'all. What, 27 game. When is she go? When is she go? About to be on the 28 game. When is she go? It's a little boy. Winning streak, y'all. It's a little boy. You know what I'm saying, bro? We're about to be on a 28 game. Winning streak, y'all. Winning streak. Y'all, it's a little boy.
And here were the Clippers arriving early, getting mentally prepared to go to work on the road. And the game arrival sponsored by Express. Dress like a pro. The Chicago River winding its way. A chance now to check out how the All-Star voting is shaping up.
And I tell you, the excitement starting to ratchet up a little bit as the tallies.
I got 8 million votes.
Now you look at Smooth. He's in the lead, sitting at number one in the West.
Clearly, the 1 million votes.
And they're giving him the highest praise possible on their ballots.
A great All-Star weekend it'll be. We'll keep you updated as we get closer.
Here on the 5 for the Clippers.
They've got G.
Clark
lights out there with Smooth.
Lost then there's Prince. So
and it's Clark in at the 5 spot. And for Chicago, Markkanen and Carter are up front. Chris Dunn is out there with White. And it's Porter in at the 3.
Oh, really?
Oh, defense. And he puts it off the glass. Wow. Here's Smooth. Oh, and he jams it right
too
over
good.
The Lowry Markkanen. Wow.
My goodness, that was absolutely filthy.
Ugh, nasty. This building is stunned. He dug deep, Greg, into his bag of tricks there. Hey, Chris, what do you think is the best way for a coach who has lost a lot to get it back?
James.
You just got to be honest and open, Kevin. You know, everyone's adults, and if you can't handle the information, then the onus is on that player. But just look at what happened in Minnesota last year. You know, just terrible in the locker room. It's not good for the fans, especially the hometown fans that believe in this young team. And so a lot of times it just comes down to clear, open communication. And the Bulls last year, Kevin, had a lot of holes in their teams. They struggled on offense as well as defense. Their lack of outside shooting was one of their bigger issues.
Defense, Chris.
And that one is stuffed right through.
And this sort of awesome dunk is one of the reasons this team is in charge of this game.
There's a swagger out there. You can see it on the court that they possess and are not afraid to show it either. Poked loose. Dunn kicks to White. Six to shoot. Here's Smooth, and he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that when he wants to.
Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Chris Dunn, bro. No.
Trying to get open his car. And there's the nice layup by Dunn. See, Webb, the Bulls last year, bottom two offense in the league.
Yeah, only slightly better than the Knicks. I mean,
because of Chris Dunn, boy. Too good.
22 different players last year. But overall, this team has a lot of work to do on the offensive end to improve.
and it's the Bulls with the ball. Trailing here by 8. This, their first look at this year's Los Angeles squad.
I did not call
Timberwolves. And with this matchup being an East versus West affair, it will be the first of only 2 meetings between the teams.
Yeah, should be a fun game to watch. I mean, 2 teams that don't see each other that much. They'll learn a lot about each other tonight.
Here's Smooth. Dunn covering. Smooth. Boy. And he takes that one up and powers it through.
Look at the window, Carter, boy. Look at the window, Carter. Too good, boy.
Especially on the offensive end.
Yeah, they've been very aggressive, and they've taken early control of this game.
Now the Clippers moving it up. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
Really seizing the momentum.
Gamatico
Vialcio
new
team approach.
Yeah, you're right, Greg. They decided to pound the ball inside.
Good, another from 3.
Nails it.
Yeah.
Is now even for the record.
Hard to believe, isn't it? His next shot from range will move him into the top spot all time for threes in a season.
Hold on, Drew Piece, let me take this 3 so I can break Curry records.
Connects again from distance.
And who thought it couldn't be done? That 3 moving him into history.
Ah, you could feel it as soon as it left his hand.
Oh my God, man. I wanted to take this. It's so good. You're going too good.
And let's check out a breakdown. Looking at some stats for him.
In the last 5 games, you can see the trend upwards for effective field goal percentage. And it shows you how confident he's playing right now.
Shot to stop the run. Goes back up. And he gets it to go as they call the foul. He's on his way to the line for 1 more.
So good.
Oh, I love the edge Carter Jr. plays with. I mean, especially on the glass where he hustles.
First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
Of course.
And you know, guys, he had a big game at the free throw line in their last outing.
Clark for 3. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
Defensively, they just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
Tipped away. Outside Porter. First quarter play. And
yo,
just
after
over
this game, I'm going to change my shoes. Yo, so you.
5 on the clock. Carter, the best to Dunn.
The defense
shot,
Clark.
So Los Angeles will take it the other way. They're coming off that win against Minnesota.
Remarkable consistency from deep. You can't count on that every game, especially on the road.
And they were connecting. And when they're connecting like that, they're hard to beat. Their accuracy from outside, just incredible.
And pushing it up, here's the Clippers.
Of course. That's my second turnover.
White looking around.
And Clark does
to
took over, yo.
Tries from 10. And it's Carter missing.
His interior scoring is one of the things that drives their offense. Don't expect him to miss many of those.
And that one's good by Clark.
3.
And here is Dunn. 20 points for him last game against Charlotte. Will it go? Jump shot is good. Dunn's got his second bucket of the night.
Evolving his offensive game. Little by little, when Dunn is pulling up like this, he's hard to guard.
Sinks the triple.
And they're getting their points now almost exclusively from the
triple.
Four of their last 5 makes are from beyond the arc.
The pass to Markkanen.
No.
Hits it from 3-point range.
Oh, this is just the leadership that Markkanen gives you. He's a competitor who enjoys drilling the Mavis triple.
And for a player that didn't come in with a lot of fanfare to the NBA, Markkanen is one of the top young players in the league.
Oh, my God,
the marksman or the finisher. Call him Larry Bird, if you like. Fantastic.
Third turnover.
Who showed he could be a focal point of an offense, can play with an edge as well, and is just scratching the surface of his potential. Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball movement.
Dunn passes to Markkanen. Good ball movement here by the Bulls. Carter outside. Does not find the basket.
Good
second miss. He's now 1 for 3. Pass the lights out. Puts up a three. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
That's a dozen straight points coming off the triple.
Guys, we've seen a lot of turnovers in this.
Focus. Just make the simple play.
Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over. Chris, you know a little something about that power forward position. Who do you think will be the best at that position? In Los Angeles, they have an exceptional
16
tonight, going
9-4. I guess I'm getting 16.4 seconds in the first quarter, bro.
And doing a good job getting to the line and capitalizing.
And so it's Porter bringing it up now for the Bulls.
Bro, y'all not gonna let the clock run out, bro. No, there's no way.
Now tied with it.
Of course, y'all gonna let the clock run out, bro. Of course. Of course he gonna let the clock run out. Of course they go run the clock, bro. Of course they go run the clock out, bro.
And what a blowout already.
But y'all not gonna make a shot.
Clippers ahead, running away with it. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number two. Paul George had that nasty broken leg back in 2000.
My inspiration really came from my mother.
So what a story. George worked hard to get back and is not disappointed in his return.
You know, recovering from a devastating injury is never easy, but George's perspective and commitment helped him to overcome it.
And glad to have you with us, folks. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. Guys, we've seen a competent-looking Clippers team out there.
I mean, offensively, I thought they did a good job of protecting the ball. And defensively, boy, were they disruptive.
Yes, yeah. Great balance of efficiency and intensity, which is why they hold the early lead.
And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. So the Bulls five right now. We've got Otto Porter Jr., Valentine out there with Wendell Carter, and it's Felicio in at the four. All right, let's catch up with our sidelines.
And I think that play sort of sums up what we've seen tonight. Just simply being outplayed both sides of the ball. Smart basketball defensively, turning into easy points.
Here's Archie Diacono. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles.
Oh, let's go home. That was just ridiculous.
I do not remember the last time I saw a dunk like that in a game.
Their team is coming again, bro.
Passes it to Felicio.
Over
James.
No.
And again, no good by Chicago. The Clippers have gone a perfect 4-of-4 since the second quarter began. Perfect from the field.
And now they're turning this game into a drag race, sprinting out for easy fast break baskets.
The Bulls have gone 1-of-3 to start out the second quarter. Knocked away. And up the floor again, the Clippers running the floor.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm. And you can see how they're finishing their play.
Too good.
Yeah, right now it feels like they can't miss. We'll see how long they can make this last.
They're not having much success at all right now.
Kevin, I would shuffle the lineup if I were their coach a little bit just to try to find something that works. Boy, you can just see the frustration growing on their faces. Nothing going their way.
It's something that happens to every team. You just have to ride it out, play your hardest, and live with the results.
Archie Diacono taking his time here. Right side, Porter. Just five on the clock. Valentine kicks to Archie Diacono. Off target with his three.
Man. That would have been a big three if he drained it. Answering back to the triple at the other end.
Well, he stepped out of bounds.
Denzel Valentine.
Hey, I gotta get Perez the ball, bro, because he got his takeover.
Now the Bulls with it. They'll be off to Oklahoma City for a meeting with the Thunder after this one. And that'll be game one of a four-game road trip. Pass to Porter. Here's Prez. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
Yeah, these defenders had better start closing down on shooters.
Archie Diacono, the pass to Carter. Here.
Who comes Clark at? Got none. Got two boards.
Here's Archie Diacono. He's still scoreless so far in this one.
It's Porter outside,
and so it looks like the Bulls will retain possession here. Shot clock at 6. Here's Dunn. Shot is good off the back rim and in. Dunn's got 6.
A lot of game nowadays is screen and roll action. I mean, Dunn looking comfortable handling it there. Yeah, they're relying on their three-point shooting and getting pretty good results.
Well, Chicago's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
From deep. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. From the arc, sinks the three-pointer. Smooth's got 39.
This system is set up perfectly for him today. I mean, it's allowing him to find a lot of good shots.
To the inside. And that one's good, Archie Diacono.
What unselfishness from the young guard. He's making to distribute the ball.
Here's James. That's his second shot and his second basket. He's 2 for 2.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flames. Oh, yeah, and that's what you love about him. He shows no mercy, even with a comfortable lead.
Done. And it's Chicago scoring again.
As hot as he's been, it still has to be him who leads the charge and helps turn this game around.
To the left wing, no one near Prez as he lets it go.
Alright. Got 7 steals. I got 7 steals.
Again, the Clippers.
And 3 more.
Give them credit. Offensively, they've been the more efficient team. Yeah, and it's because of the looks they're getting. Their offense has created some great opportunities.
Here's Dunn. Move. And they cash in right away with a quick shot. He's got 10.
Alright.
Dunn's gone 5 of 8 from the field, shooting over 60%. And it goes down 2 points.
And he delivers another blow. Something's gotten into him this quarter. He's carrying them offensively.
Got me to go over again, yo. See, y'all knew that.
It's Carter.
See, y'all knew the new team is coming again, bro.
Back to Dunn.
That's some great defense.
Clark with the rebound. Clark's got 11 rebounds in the game. Here's Smooth. Dunn covering. Gets it to go from beyond the arc. Smooth's got 44.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight. Yeah, that's why he's hot. He's playing with a lot of confidence. That's why they're going to him with such consistency.
Here's Dunn. It's Clark with the rebound. Clark's got 12 rebounds here tonight. Big time effort.
Yet another bucket in close.
Too good.
That's how he's earning his points today.
And here's Dunn. He'll bring it up for the Bulls. Defeated by the Hornets in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
And, you know, you have to feel terrible about how that thing turned out. I mean, the game was really going about as expected until they just gave up that huge surge there late in the game, totally lost momentum, and ended up losing that one. And you look at Wendell Carter Jr., the center out of Duke, fantastic blend of size and mobility. A lot to like about what he can do.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Markkanen comes in for Felicia. And it's wide in for Ryan Archie Diacono. It's 2-on-1. Jumps up. And another one falls.
And the 50-point games continue to add up for him.
Well, every game takes him closer
Cowboy
to the next
boy.
Next up, second
the Cowboy
place
celebration.
And Wilt had 30 games of 50 points or more back in 1963. And that number gets closer and closer with games like this.
Young's checked in for Chicago.
Converting the third point, boy. I'm getting the 3 points to old-fashioned, boy.
Well, Chicago's gone 0-3 from beyond the arc to start the second quarter. Knocks it loose.
Yeah, Prince. Stolen by defense.
And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles, and James throws it down.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play, then the emphatic stuff.
Oh, yeah, bang, bang. An impressive sequence that has them fired up.
And with Wendell Carter Jr., we saw flashes of his potential last season.
Easy to see why he was.
And so it's Los Angeles, able to put on a show for the ages. And with as many three-pointers as they've drained, it's easy to see why they're on the cusp of a blowout. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks so much. Kawhi, you seem to be so at ease out there. How much is that helping your game?
It's helping me out a lot. Just coming in the game relaxed, just with more intensity. I mean, my teammates are getting me involved on the offensive end. I'm playing great on defense. We just got to keep it up second half and not let it up.
Hey, Kawhi, thank you very much for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. And we'll be right back after halftime to start the third quarter. See you in just a bit.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Ernie Johnson. Kenny the Jet Smith is right here. Say hey to the folks, Kenny.
Hey, folks.
Say hey to the folks, Shaq.
Hey, folks.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Right out of the gates, it was the Clippers setting the tone, displaying the force of a tidal wave and some excellent offensive and defensive possessions. They surged their way to a 14-2 start. They delivered a real beatdown in the first quarter, ending with a whopping lead. Then in quarter number two, it was all hands on deck, and what a show it was. Quality execution, good efficiency, some tremendous defensive play helped them take a decisive advantage, and they're running away with this one. And taking a look at the Clippers, Kenny, what did you see out there?
That was the half of the super sub for them. A lot of offense coming off the bench. That's such a luxury to have that kind of firepower available. There were times when the pace picked up when the second unit came into the game. And that's the best part, having a bunch of guys who's ready at the drop of a hat.
And Shaq, what'd you think about Chicago?
Well, they got a ton of issues to work out. Allow way too high a percentage to be shot against them. Not really showing any energy on defense, no discipline. Look at their faces, Ernie. Do they even want to be here?
And that'll do it for us. The third quarter about to begin with Kevin Harlan standing by. We'll catch you on the flip side.
My brother.
All right. You know what I'm saying, bro.
Why don't you put it on the way? And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. What a game we're seeing from Smooth.
Well, with a double-double in hand through two quarters, you can...
Boy, you dunked him, boy.
Intensity, did you see that? Great.
Look in the window, Cody, boy.
How about
boy.
Just
too
floating
good.
To the rim on that slam?
Boy, when he gets up, I mean, he gets up. Bulls shooting 28%, a rocky, rocky performance for them offensively. Done outside. He's looking for Porter and finds him. And finished off by Porter.
Porter's a remarkable athlete. Someone who gets off the floor fast and sharp.
To the right side. Clark for three, and again, it's the Clippers from deep.
And this is the game plan for him. He's a big part of their floor space.
Well, when he's hitting from range on a consistent basis, it makes everything easier offensively.
Porter passes to White.
No.
The Clippers grab the miss.
Well, I thought that one was going to go down. The mid-range jumpers, oh, man, that's usually a bunny with the D playing soft like that.
And this is how you want to come out of the half. Prolific and efficient.
Oh, just a dream scenario for them so far. Their offense looking like a well-oiled machine.
There's the pass to Carter. Back to Dunn. Clock at six. Looking to get back on track here.
Dude.
It's rebounded by Prince.
Very aggressive defense to prevent the easy layup.
As athletic a move as you're going to see boy. Right there.
360 boy.
The hang time on that thing. Wow. First minute and a half of basketball here in the third quarter. Markkanen dishes to Porter. Dunn outside. Can they get it? No good that time.
That's good defense.
The Clippers go the other way with it.
Might take them a little while to find their stride here in the second half. Only 1-for-4 so far. They just need to calm down, play their game.
Three-pointers are killing them at this point, and they haven't been able to respond at the other end.
Dishes at the Porter. Right side, White. Done outside.
Ooh.
Tried to come right back with a three of his own, but it's no good. Here's Smooth. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
If they close this win out, I know who my MVP is. His offensive performance tonight has been unreal.
It's tipped.
Coming to court, the big team is coming.
It's deflected, and they'll keep possession. Buddy
Stanton. Oh, get the board.
Markkanen passes to Dunn. And in last, they get one to fall.
Clark, that's took over me too, yo.
And it's important that Markkanen develops his floor awareness. Big team boys. Like there, go a long way.
Talk about execution on the offensive end. Big team boys, big team boys. They're leaving nothing on the table right now.
Absolutely relentless. They're in the flow and riding that wave for as long as they can.
Big team boys.
Dunn kicks to Porter. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by James. Now we get a chance to check out the standings out west. Already we're in December. You look at the Clippers. And not a surprise, really, to see them sitting there in that number one spot in the conference. The excellent brand of basketball they've been putting on display lately has been terrific.
And when you look at the Clippers, they have caught the entire league off guard. This was not a position anyone thought they'd be in at this stage of the season.
Yeah, Greg, I mean, they had a plan coming into the year. I mean, they stuck to it, and it's worked to perfection.
And finish off by Prince.
Hey, whatever adjustments they made at halftime, they are working to perfection.
Well, the results are clear as day. Great approach coming into the third quarter. We'll see if they can keep it up.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
There's the three. Drains the three-pointer. 5 points in the game.
An assertive offensive player. White knows he has the green light to rise and fire.
And again for three. Buries his 10th triple of the game.
Unbelievable.
And here's Dunn. He'll bring it up for Chicago. Poked away. That's a floater go. A shot, no good.
James with some nice deep.
He's forcing things a little bit in this quarter, settling for shots that he'd be better off passing up.
And that one's good by Clark.
And perimeter scoring, I have to imagine it was a topic of discussion at halftime.
Well, it had to be. These days, you need to stretch the floor somewhat to make everything else work.
Carter, the pass to White. With the shot, and it's wide right, hits off the rim.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive. That is not possible. What we just, is that possible?
I think it is, Greg. Not probable, but like possible, like you said. And here again, Los Angeles in transition. Up the court they go.
Kevin, is there another player out there capable of moves as stunning as that?
A handful at the most. He is an elite company. Markkanen down low. Working on James. Markkanen dishes to White. Looking to end the run.
No.
Hands it from downtown. White's got his third bucket of the night.
Their three-point percentage has taken a big leap here in this second half.
Good! Another from three. You can tell he is feeling it.
Kevin, he's on fire.
Frez with the ball. Now guarded by Dunn. Here's lights out, and down it goes. Dunk threw off a wonderful assist.
With the Kobe Dunk, boy. With the LeBron James Dunk.
Perfect example of how to with run the break dunk. The right way. And get a great
I'm going to take over again, yo. See, all the big team is coming again. Bert and Perez. Guys, take over into the pitch.
Defense right on him.
Guys, take over.
Kicks it to Carter. And what a play. Just snatched out of the air.
Clark. Snatching the ball out of his hand.
Really, almost playing for the other team. The shooting has just been
snatching the ball.
So aggressive at that end of the floor. And that's a quality all great scorers have.
Will Clark snatching the ball out Carter's hand.
How done.
Clark
points for him.
Snatching the ball out Carter's hand, bro. I like that.
Marking
and
down.
And James got six
James over. Covering. To the middle. Here's Dunn. And it's the Clippers with the rebound.
Well, he has to work harder to get a good high percentage look.
Bro, I mean, that's my third turn. That's my fourth.
Get some bad shots out there.
He dishes it to Carter. Outside, White to stop the run. It's Clark with the rebound. Clark's got rebound number 17, if you can believe that.
Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
Well, part of their game plan was to block out the noise and just stay focused. Well, Greg, their poise has been tremendous. I mean, excellent at both ends has them increasing this lead.
Bro, shoot. Man, I'm not going to get him up.
Carter outside. Outside, White. And it's done in the corner. Five to shoot.
Two
the Clippers grab the miss. Smooth's got four rebounds in this game.
He's disappeared this quarter. He can't get anything to drop. That's not going to help him get out of the hole.
Yeah, again, just a lackluster transition defense.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
And he uses both hands to jam it in.
Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
Starting to take over here, building a big lead that could ultimately prove insurmountable.
And we have an intentional foul there.
Oh my God. I guess so then, 40.1 seconds left in the third quarter. In the third quarter, bro. Right here, Kawhi, what you doing?
40 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's Smooth. And the layup's good off the glass.
And with the game he's having, there's no doubt he'll be the guy they lean on to protect the lead.
White against Johnson. A different look for the Clippers. James comes in for Kawhi Leonard. And lights out, subbed in for Magic Johnson.
Lights out.
26 seconds left in the third. The shot's good.
Decent at casting in from the mid-range. I mean, it's obvious that Dunn wants to improve his jumper.
Smooth passes to Jay. And again, Los Angeles with the triple. Well, Chicago's gone a less than productive 2 of 6 from three-point land in the second half. They get a hand on it. And pushing it up, here's the Clippers. Here's Smooth, three-pointer, and got it! Another basket! He's been absolutely ridiculous in this game.
You get the sense he just can't miss.
And so it's Los Angeles, enjoying the kind of gigantic lead you almost never see. Their defense has been active and effective. And we'll be right back after this. And a quick look now at the State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Well, it's also called making a good read, understanding where everyone is and taking full advantage. Fantastic.
And one quarter to go in a game that to this point has not been evenly fought contest. The NBA will play a regular season game in Paris for the first time. Hornets and Bucks. Chris, you're planning to be there for that, aren't you?
Such a beautiful city. Can't wait. And think about all our players.
The Tomahawk, boy. The Tomahawk. Too good, boy. The Tomahawk.
In front of their families.
Valentine out there with Harrison, and it's Felicio in at the center filling out the middle. That's the five out there for the Bulls. Inside, here's Harrison, nails the baby hook. Harrison's got his first bucket in this one.
Yeah, the D has not been able to keep the ball out of the paint at that end of the floor.
Here's Smooth, yet another bucket.
He just notched 92 points on that one.
Simply surreal. GA, I'm not sure even he can believe what's going on right now. Back to Harrison. And it's the Clippers with the rebound.
The D making that layup look very uncomfortable for him. Good aggressive work down low.
He's putting on a show for these fans.
I can't believe he pulled that one out in the course of an actual game. Just over a minute played here in the fourth. Out of bounds, Bulls ball, Chicago keeps possession. More star players changing teams. The word tampering comes up, Chris. Is the league striking the right balance on enforcement?
Oh, yes. And, you know, Commissioner Silver, he knows all the tricks. He doesn't want to be a police state, but he knows a wink from a wink.
Right,
you know
yes.
what I mean? So you got to draw some lines. But, again, how do you stop it? I mean, you know, if I'm playing on the Lakers and I say, wow.
That's true.
I think Anthony Davis has the best eyebrows in the world. You know, you got to let me say that. And, you know, if that's recruiting, it's recruiting. So it's a fine line, and hopefully the players have some fun with it, and hopefully Commissioner Silver does his best to police it while everyone at the same time is working with integrity.
They need this. Here's Felicio, and the rejection by Zubats. Here's Smooth. Good. Great play by Williams to set it up. Smooth's got 9 points in the quarter.
And you can see now they're starting to push the tempo to good effect.
Pass to Felicio. Just under 2.5 minutes gone here in the final quarter. Passes it to Hutchison. Just 5 to shoot. Fires it up. And it's in after a nice bounce off the right side.
If there's ever a successful shot that still gets your coach mad at you, that's the one.
And it's on a bounce to the Clippers as the Clippers retain possession. A chance to check out Los Angeles' upcoming schedule. On Tuesday, they'll head back home to host the Phoenix Suns. And then on Thursday, they'll go up against Russell Westbrook and the Houston Rockets. There's Williams with the three and another three for the Clippers.
Yeah, great outside shooting. Really fueling this run.
They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, they're off it.
Oh, that was an impressive throwdown.
Nasty. Yeah, boy.
And this offense is in a perfect rhythm. And you can see how they're finishing their plays.
Yeah, right now it feels like they can't miss. We'll see how long they can make this last.
Knocked loose. And here again, Los Angeles in transition. Up the court they go.
Well, if you don't take care of the ball, fellas, that's what can happen.
Absolutely great. That makes the turnover even more painful.
Yeah, going defense to offense in an instant. Every team now calibrated to do that.
Here's Smooth. Finish off the break.
And the transition D right now, just non-existent.
The Bulls have gone just 33% from the field in the fourth quarter so far. They are 2 of 6. And the layup falls.
Chain, boy.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively
Patrick
right now.
And Patrick Beverly does take over, yo.
On the interior.
Patrick does take over. Patrick. Patrick Beverly does take over, yo. Patrick Beverly does take over.
Now, here's Valentine.
So, yeah.
Here's Smooth, and another three for the Clippers.
And how about the pressure they're able to now start to apply, taking advantage of every miscue.
Here we go, one-on-one. And down it goes, jamming that one home.
And that dunk reverberated throughout this entire building.
It sure did. Up high and down hard on the windmill flush.
It's windmill.
The Bulls shooting 27%. The offense is just embarrassing
it's
themselves.
Windmill.
Beverly wide open. And another three for the Clippers.
Well, and this has been their strategy throughout the fourth period. We'll see how it pans out.
Well, as long as they're hitting like this, how can you blame them? They're on a tear.
And there's the pass to Harrison to end the cold streak. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. And now, yep, this will be a coach's challenge. We thought that might happen.
That's not a review, bro, of
the personal foul.
That's not no foul, bro. That is not no foul.
And I think when it comes to some of the more difficult calls to make, personal fouls can be tough. The action is so fast that it's really tough to catch everything in real time.
The wonders of technology, Greg. We've seen replay reviews so effectively and involving the coaches by being able now to challenge like this is something a lot of people have been hoping for. And the announcement on the review is that the foul was called in error. So they have determined, Greg, to overrule the original call.
And guys, this is what it's all about. Getting the call right. And I think in this case, the video review shows that while it was a tough call to make on the floor, they got it right.
Here's Smooth. And again, Los Angeles with the triple.
It's no wonder why they're in front when you take into consideration that he's been perfect from the field so far.
Pass to Hutchison. Back to Valentine. Here's Gafford, and the rejection by Harrell. Here's Smooth, and it's the Clippers scoring again.
As hot as he's been this quarter, the game plan is simple, folks. Get him the ball and get out of the way.
An intentional foul committed, but for what purpose? How great the Clippers signing of Kawhi Leonard. The grand finale of the wildest summer in NBA free agent history.
How many points did Jay get? He got 12.
A ton of big moves. You think of the star players who've changed teams, one-third of the league's all-NBA selections, and 5 out of 10 reigning all-star starters. In the end, we saw 7 players who've changed teams, signing for over $100 million each. Put that in perspective, only 8 players had ever done that in league history.
And the Clippers call time here. And the stretch big man, Lauri Markkanen, very strong player on offense.
And I told you, Kevin, it's no secret. I like Markkanen best when he is a bit greedy, searching for a shot. I mean, sometimes I feel he can defer too much, but he has the skills to be a great scoring threat if he is playing aggressive.
And the Clippers making a change here. Zubats is checked in for Jay. Montrezl Harrell comes in for James. Paul George is checked in for Prez. And Lights Out subbed in for Magic Johnson. These guys have had some good motion on offense. Nice assisting.
And whenever here he comes, and there he goes.
Look at him punish that rim. Chicago has gone ice cold from three-point land, 0-4 since the start of the final quarter. Here's Archie Diacono. Rebound by the Clippers. Here's Smooth. Here's Zubats, and another assist, and that's his 20th assist. Wow.
Just doing a great job at orchestrating the offense. They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
And that's an intentional foul.
Really no idea why you're fouling in a situation like that. You know, maybe there's some bad blood between those two.
Catching up on the changes for the Clippers. Jay's checked in for Zubats. James comes in for Harrell. And Prez is subbed in for George. Shot clock at 5. Here's Hutchison. And again, no good by Chicago. Here's Smooth. Oh, and he jams it right over Wendell Carter. Wow.
He's playing lights out right now. I mean, inspired basketball in the second half.
Poor spacing, Chris, now so big in the NBA. And big men have the room to put up some unbelievable numbers.
Oh, man, look at Lopez out there. And Bucks,
let's go with you, yo. See all the new teams. From
deep. Same thing. We got to go to Embiid, Porzingis. And we already see what the great Dirk Nowitzki has done through his career. Look, it adds time on to your career because you don't have to just go down there and bang and be one-dimensional in the paint. It makes your teammates better because now you're spacing the floor, which gives them room to drive. And if you're really working on your game, you can really make your teammates better because now you have more passing lanes because you're further away from the basket. So as any post player knows, it's a blessing to be surrounded by great shooters. And now big men, they got a little more room out there.
And as we head to the final buzzer here, a crushing blowout, big time dominance, and this will go in the record books as a gaudy win for Los Angeles.
The bench gave him a big lift in this game.
Hey, listen, Kevin, anytime your reserves can perform at a level that high, it puts you in an excellent position to win the game.
And now on the year, this will take them to 28 wins.
And so up and up he goes as he continues this sensational season, now closing in on second place in scoring.
And GA, with the way he has manhandled defenses all year long, you have to think he'll make a good run for it.
And to even come near Wilt's mark of 3,586 points from back in 63 speaks volumes for the season he's had.
Here's Archie Diakono. Ball's knocked loose. There's the triple. That shot is off. Here's Smooth. And again, it's the Clippers from deep.
I mean, he hit that shot from the next town over, Kev. What a shot.
Archie Diakono, the pass to Carter. Over to the left wing.
No.
Here's Harrison. Off target from three-point range. From deep, connects again.
244.
He's really sniping the front
score, yo. 244.
Feeling confident in that
three-point
shot.
Right, let me check these stats, like always. I had 130 points, 6 boards, 20 assists, 17 steals, 2 blocks, 4 turnovers. I had 30 dunks. Prayers at 16 points. Jerry Pitts at 15. Luke Clark got a double-double. Magic had 12. Jay had 12. Kawhi had 11. PG had 10. James had 9. Patrick had 8 points. Lewis had 3. And Zuba had 3. Alright, I'm saying, bruh. Perez had 1 dunk. Drew Pierce had 2 dunks. Magic had 1 dunk. James had 1 dunk. Alright.
So the Clippers winning this one easily. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking.
Wait, hold on. Chris Dunn had 16 points. He shot 8 for 22. This dude was 3 for... Kobe White was 3 for 12. Otto Porter was 2 for 6. Wendell Carter was 2 for 7. They all trash.
I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Paul. Congrats on the win. Where is your team's attitude right now?
Continue to, you know, play together. And we can just stick to that, keep working, staying confident, keep defending, and knocking shots down, we'll be all right.
Looks like it all came together tonight, Paul. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David. Great interview once again. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Chris Webber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.
Big cheese. That was pretty blue. art. Next game going against the Phoenix Suns. Alright, let me change my shoes. Alright, let me change Duke Clark shoes first. So you. I'm tired of useless. I just wanna get my money. Let it go. Hard to blow. Alright, let me save you. No. Alright, let's save you. It's loading. Alright. If y'all like this video, man, like and subscribe. Tip the channel, turn the post notification so you never miss the upload. And go follow me on Peace for y'all at 2011-2593. And still to my second Antonio Pitts. Peace, I love y'all. And I'll see you guys in my next video. It's really y'all.